Hello, this is Nopename. Today I want to show you my player ID system. Maybe some of you have already has already done something like that before, but I haven't seen it the way I did it. So the special thing about this is there's a static ID and a dynamic ID. Here you can see the static ID. And static ID means this is just the number of a player that joined the world. So I joined this world as the first player ever with my main account, and then as the second player with my second account, and if another player would join, he would get the ID 3 and so on. And every player would keep his score forever. And then there's also a dynamic ID. Discovered objectives at display sidebar player ID dynamic. And don't be confused by this date right here that both players have the same ID. Every player that is currently in the world has a unique ID, but if so I'm on my own in this world now. And if I would join with my second account as well, he would get ID 2. He has the same ID than me, only because he is not in the world at the moment. And it would, as I said, update as soon as he joins. And there shouldn't be too much of a problem, because if you do something like this, say, add a, so every player that has a score, player ID dynamic of 1, it only displays my name, because I'm the only player with a dynamic ID 1 in the world currently. So this shouldn't be any problem. And the thing about this is every player will keep his score as long he's inside the world, and as soon as he rejoins, he might get a new ID. So imagine these armor strands are players, and on the bottom you can see their static IDs, and on the top their dynamic IDs. So let's turn off the static IDs for now, because this might confuse you. So these armor strands, or these players joined in this order. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's why they have these IDs. And now let's say player one is leaves the game. And as I said before, the score will stay like this. And now player two will leave as well. And now player two will join. I can't set the armor stand here for whatever reason. Summon armor stand. So yeah, he joins before player one, and so he will get a dynamic ID of 1. And now we have a situation I showed before. And now this armor stand or player will join, and now he will look through all the IDs. So he starts at 1, but there's already a player with dynamic ID 1, so he will check if there's a player with dynamic ID 2, and there's not, so he will get dynamic ID 2. I hope you understand the idea behind this, and I think that's quite useful, because that way you don't get infinitely high IDs. And yeah, I'm not so sure if you are able to use this for something. I definitely want to use this for some maps, that's why I made this system. But maybe some of you need this as well. And so yeah, that's why there's a download link in the description, and you can check it out. It's a data pack, and you simply put it into the data pack folder inside the world folder. And then you just have to join the world again and it should load. If there is no chat message, then just do reload and this should show up. And now everything should work. So yeah, there's one or there's two problems. Well, actually, the first one I already showed you, that there is that sometimes players have the same dynamic ID, but as I also told you, that shouldn't be any problem because only one of those players is actually in the world. But there's another actual problem, the static IDs. If you do a scoreboard, players reset and then me, for example, then also the dynamic and static IDs will be removed. And for example, let's do it with player one and reset his score. So he won't have any static ID anymore and no dynamic ID. And now he will rejoin and now he will get a new static ID because he doesn't have any ID so far. And now the game will select ID number 6 because he's the 6th player to join the world. So yeah, that's maybe a problem, but as long as you don't use scoreboard players reset for all the scores, then you should be fine. And yeah, that's already it for this video. I hope that's useful for you. And as I said, you can download it and you can use it in your own maps and so on. And yeah, that's it. See you next time. Bye.